Okay, so the next topic I'm going to talk about is normal distribution probabilities. To understand this, there's actually something I want to talk about briefly first, which is z-score transforming a whole distribution, or equivalently, data set. So let's stick with a familiar example of women's height. So we know that the mean is 65, standard deviation is 3.5, and these are inches. This is women's height. And what we're going to do is we're going to z-score transform this distribution. So to do that, we're going to calculate the z-score for all scores in the distribution. And then this is what we'll end up with. We'll have a frequency distribution. It's still going to be a normal distribution. This one's normal. This will have the exact same shape of the original one. It's going to have a mean of 0 and a standard deviation of 1. To kind of give a better sense of how this would work, we'll do z-score transformations of some of the raw score to see where those scores fall over here. And we're working with population data, so our z-score formula is the score minus the population mean divided by the population standard deviation. So if we just look at the women whose raw score is 65 inches, right, their z is going to be 65 minus the mean, which is 65, divided by the standard deviation, which is 3.5. So they're going to be 0 divided by 3.5. Their z-score is going to be 0. So that is where all the women at that height are going to end up in the middle here still. Okay. And then if we next consider women who are one standard deviation over, they would be 68.5 inches tall. They would right here, because 65 plus 3.5 is 68.5. So let's see where they would end up over here. So z equals their score of 68.5 minus the mean of 65, divide that by the standard deviation, 3.5, and you will get 3.5 divided by 3.5, or 1. So all of the women at 68.5 are now over at 1. So there's a 1-to-1 correspondence in the shape, such that the mean turns into a 0 and the standard deviation turns into a 1. That's what happens when you do a z-score transformation of any distribution, but in this case we're focusing on the normal distribution. When we do this z-score transformation, we take this data over here, which is the raw data. It's in the original units of inches, and we transform it so that it's now all z-score transformed data. So this is a normal distribution. And there's a lot of variables that have a normal distribution, but once you z-score transform any normal distribution, what you end up with is what's called a standard normal distribution. So all standard normal distributions have a normal shape, a mean of 0, and a standard deviation of 1. And so any normal distribution can be transformed into a standard normal distribution. And one thing that's really nice about that is that you can compare variables that have different units, inches or height or something like that. You can standardize them to the same kind of distribution, and you can compare heights with heights with weights or whatever you want, any kind of variable that is interval or ratio, and therefore can be a on this kind of a distribution, as long as it's normally distributed originally. So all variables that have a normal distribution and have been z-score transformed and therefore share this exact same distribution, these are really common. And so really what we're going to talk about for normal distribution probabilities, you could call it standard normal distribution probabilities, because whenever we talk about probabilities with a normal distribution, we use the standard normal distribution as our reference. So that's what we're going to be doing as we move forward now. And so we're going to start off when we're talking about the standard normal distribution probabilities with a simplified version. So we'll get into more complicated versions in a little bit, but for now, just to introduce this idea, we're going to start off with a simplified version. And for that, we'll draw our normal distribution and try to draw lines where each of the z-scores are. So the mean, one standard deviation above the mean, two standard deviations above the mean, three above the mean, one, two, and three standard deviations below the mean. Because the normal distribution is always the same shape, people have calculated what area under this curve is between 0 and 1 standard deviation, right? So under the curve, overall, it's 100% of the area, but that 100% can be calculated for each of these. And it turns out that in between 0 and 1%, it's about 34% of the overall area, about one-third. And because it's a symmetrical distribution, between 0 and 1 is going to be the same as between 0 and negative 1. So there's 34% here as well. In between 1 and 2 is about 14% of the area. So between negative 1 and negative 2, it's also going to be about 14% of the area. And in between 2 and 3, it's approximately 2% of the area. All right, so with this approximation, we have a total of 16, 50, 100% of the area. Right, in reality, there is more of the area beyond 3, but in the simplification, we're going to ignore that, right? That's why one reason it's simplified. Now, another way to think about this is that in between negative 1 and 1, there is 68% of the whole area. If you go out to negative 2 to 2, we're up to 95%. Now that's not exactly what this math adds up to here. It would have been, what would that be, 96%. But this is a slightly different way of calculating it that's a little bit more accurate. And if we go all the way out to 3 standard deviations, it is 99.7%. So that means that almost the whole area under a normal distribution is within 3 standard deviations, right? And what I've drawn here is sometimes called, sometimes called the empirical rule. And it's just kind of a rule of thumb to give you a sense of, with a normal distribution, where do most of the scores lie. And almost 70% are within one standard deviation from the mean either way. 95% are within 2 standard deviations, and almost 100% are within 3 standard deviations. So if you're an individual that is 3 standard deviations above the mean, you're taller than, for example, 99.7% of other people.